All right, the next thing I'm going to show you how to do is the white space with paint.net, which is another free program. Paint.net is similar to GIMP, except that it's Windows only, and it might be a little bit easier to use, but it's also more limited in that regard. And you need a few extra things to install, like a .NET framework. But if you can manage that, then you should be able to do pretty good with here, too. Alright, once we install and open up paint.NET, your layout should look pretty much exactly like mine, because there's really not much you can do to change it. we're going to go to File, Open. We're going to go to wherever we saved the image file. We're going to open it up. Here it is. Once again, just to make it a little bit easier, let's increase the size a little bit so we can see what we're doing. With this one, we don't need to add an alpha layer because it assumes there already is one. So, once again, just like last time, we're going to go to the tools where these little colorful icons are. Look for the magic wand. Click it. The tolerance now is at 50%, which is way too much. So, just click the bar and bring it down to about 15% like GIMP was at. And hopefully we'll get similar results, right? When that's done, once again, just click white space, click it anywhere. And as you can see, it selects the white space, much like GIMP. Might not be entirely as accurate, but it does the same exact job pretty much. And once again on your keyboard, just press delete. And as you can see, it's done. It's nice, no background. It should show up rather well on light backgrounds like white, light gray, stuff like that. And if it doesn't, then once again you could, you know, change it around, maybe feather the edges. But other than that, you remove the white space, and congratulations, you should be having a nice image, right? So what we want to do to save it is click File, Save As, and like last time, just change the extension to .png so we could maintain transparency, or we could save as a GIF, whichever, because there's not much in it, but we'll get into that later. We'll save, and here you can change the preferences, but they're pretty much good as they are, so just click OK. And that's it. You're done. All right. Once again, like last time, if you need any extra help, let me know, and I'll be happy to help you. If I missed something or went too fast on something, once again, you know, just tell me too, and I'll do my best to rectify the issue. But I think this should cover it, all right? Okey-dokey, then. I hope it helped.